कॉन्टेजियस डिजीजेस, कॉन्टेजियस और कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस आर दोज डिजीजेस विच कैन स्प्रेड फ्रॉम वन पर्सन टू अनदर बाय डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट। ऑल इन्फेक्शन डिजीजेज मे और मे नॉट बी कॉन्टेजियस। इन अ फ्लू एन इन्फेक्शन इन्फेक्शस पैथोजन फाइंड्स इट्स वे इन टू द बॉडी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ फ्लू वायरस, एंड स्प्रेड्स टू अदर पीपल बाय कॉन्टैक्ट, दैट इज टचिंग और शेकिंग हैंड्स और इवन स्नीजिंग। बट इन्फेक्शस डिजीज विच आर नॉट कॉन्टेजियस इंक्लूड्स फूड पॉइजनिंग, फॉर एग्जाम्पल बैक्टीरियल फूड पॉइजनिंग। इन दिस द एजेंट फाइंड्स इट वे इन टू द बॉडी बाय ईटिंग ऑफ कॉन्टामिनेटेड फूड, but this is not spread by contact. And the prevention of the communicable diseases can which are infectious and contagious at the same time can be done by maintaining hygiene and washing hands frequently with proper vaccination, use of antibiotics or medications, and social distancing, and or also safe sexual practices. Communicable diseases which spread by infectious agent, this illness is caused by microscopic organisms which are spread normally through direct contact. Localized diseases, infectious or neoplastic process that originate in and is confined to one organ or system or general area in the body, such as sprained ankle, a boil on hand or an abscess in finger, are referred to as localized diseases. A localized cancer that has not extended beyond the margins of organs involved can also be described as localized disease, while cancer that extended into the tissue are described as invasive. Some diseases are capable of changing from local to disseminated diseases. For example, pneumonia, which is generally confined to one or both lungs, can become disseminated through sepsis. Systemic diseases. Diseases that affect the entire body rather than single organ or body part. It involves many organs and tissues at once, and it's a group of complex symptoms and signs. Examples of systemic diseases are diabetes mellitus. For example, diabetes mellitus has micro and macrovascular complications. In macrovascular complications, diabetes can cause diabetic retinopathy, diabetic neuropathy, or diabetic nephropathy. In macrovascular complications, it can cause atherosclerosis and can lead to MI. So it is a whole sum of diseases. Second example can be hypertension. Hypertension can cause damage to vital organs, can cause blood vessel damage, which can lead to MI, formation of atherosclerosis, or it can also lead to formation of infarct in a brain, which can lead to stroke. Third can be higher cholesterol. Higher cholesterol can also cause atherosclerosis, which can lead to stroke or it can lead to MI problem. So it can involve both brain and heart. The fourth can be hyperthyroidism. In hyperthyroidism we can have, or hypothyroidism also, we can have various symptoms because thyroxine hormone is related to the metabolism of body functions, and in case of increased or decreased BMR you can have symptoms, various symptoms of different body organs. For example, if there is hypothyroidism, then we can have increased heart rate, we can have weight loss, we can have amenorrhea. Also, in contrast, if there is hypothyroidism, we can have increased weight, deposition of fat in subcutaneous tissue, which is known as myxedema. We can have bradyarrhythmia, we can have fatigue, we can have symptoms of hypermenorrhagia also. Lifestyle diseases. Ailments whose occurrence is primarily linked with day-to-day life habits of an individual are known as lifestyle diseases. Lifestyle diseases can be, first we can call as heart diseases in general, which includes coronary artery disease, or it can have myocardial infarction, and it can be due to lifestyles like poor diet or high BP or obesity. The diagnosis can be made on the basis of CT, MRI or coronary angiography, blood tests in which we have various cardiac biomarkers, for example troponin and creatine kinase. Type 2 diabetes is also a lifestyle disease, and being overweight or lack of exercise and obesity can lead to diabetes mellitus. although it can have a genetic predisposition, but these factors are also involved in the multifactorial development of disease. And third can be stroke. Also stroke can also have lifestyle risk factors like high BP or diabetes or high cholesterol or smoking. Hypertension, also a disease in its own, can have risk factors or history. For example, they can have family history, or it can be tobacco use, obesity, excessive salt intake, in which there is sodium, and too low calcium, potassium intake. COPD, also a lifestyle disease in which we can have the problems of passive smoking, working with chemicals or dust fumes, or this can be a lifestyle part habits which can lead to COPD, which is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Lastly, we can also have osteoporosis, which can be linked to vitamin D deficiency or smoking or low calcium diet.